hear us in the car, toot the horn. Amen, amen.
Praise God. Thank you.
The Lord is good.
Hallelujah.
We heard the brother was singing a song when they came in. Folks got happy.
Amen.
He's a good God.
Yes,
and he's worthy to be praised.
Yes.
So I have the real saints that don't mind standing up here, God. Let's go and give God praise.
Church can get that in their mind. It's not about you.
It's not us. Together, by the tribe, go up the tribe of the Lord unto the testimony of Israel to give thanks unto the name of the Lord. But they are set thrones of judgment, the thrones of the house of David. Pray for the peace of Jerusalem. They shall prosper that love thee. Peace be within thy walls. Just look around between these walls. Look around. Peace between these walls. Glory to God. You ought to get happy right there. We have peace within these walls. Amen. And prosperity within thy palace. We got prosperity right in here. In these walls, then we got what? Prosperity. For my brother, you come and say, I will not say, peace be within thee. Because in the house of the Lord our God, I will seek.
I'm still in the land of the living. That's my testimony. I'm
still in my right mind. That's my testimony. You took another way. People are dying every day. All day. You're still here. People die all day. Every day. But I thank God. Sister Watkins came in this morning. Sister Pickle came in. They came in with a praise. Just what church is all about. Thank God I made it one more day. So if you have a testimony, you may share it at this time.
Yes.
It
was so strong. I went to the mailbox one day and I grabbed
Christ's body is different. If something don't work, don't do it. You can give me everything you want to. I don't mean that to put it in my mouth. So we have to use our own wisdom and knowledge. If something bothers you, and sometimes people just push pills, just push medication, and they look at you as being subhuman anyway, three-fourths of a person. So they might give you anything, but you got to use wisdom. Godly wisdom. Amen? Amen. Sister Deborah.
I don't think he did me right. I mean, I don't even really think house. Just get it onto the house. So we dropped it off at the Chevrolet place. They checked it out. I was like, what car are you going to know how much it's going to cost? So I was like, okay. I was like, gosh, you got one car in the shop. You ready? Like, I got the discipline there. So I was just sitting there. At work, and I called. I tried to call mom. I couldn't get her because I was like, I need some prayer like really quick. I need God to work on God. Like, fast. I was like, because I don't have a money like this. So then,
sometimes God has to reshape us to make us fit in His kingdom. If God don't break you, you can't make it, sisters and brothers. Life is about breaking and making. But I learned one thing The Bible says the way of a transgress is hard. And I didn't understand that for years, but when you transgress against God, things begin to be harder and harder and harder. Until you hit, when you finally hit your head against the wall and say, you know what, this is not working. I'm going to have to change me. You can't change nobody else, but you can change who? You. I can't change my wife, she can't change me, but I got to change in order for God to bless me. And a lot of times we as saints, we do all kind of things trying to make things happen, but you bump your head against the wall enough time, you realize this ain't working. And you find out the only way it's going to work is I got to change.
Yes.
This starts with me. And when you give God your heart, give God your mind, your soul, and your spirit, God will change you from the inside out. He'll make you a better person. And all of us need to be a better person. Not one in this building don't need to be better. Amen? We're working on ourselves, saints. And we're going to go through trials and tribulations. But one thing about it, if you live holy, you live right, God will bless you. Like he touched that man's heart. He had touched other folks' heart. We're saints. We're saints. Ask what you will. That's what he said, right? And he'll bless you. So she experienced that let her know that God is still working with me. He's still working with me. Davis had a car they wanted. $1,100 to fix the air conditioning. That's okay. So I took the car back and gave him a car. Gave him a Mini Cooper. I took the old car. I didn't need the car, but I was trying to help them. I went online and ordered a compressor for $100. Got to fix it for $64. And then I gave him a tip. So it went from $1,100 to $164. That's wisdom, because I'm older and I know what to do. They're young, they don't know what to do. They just accept what people tell them. Amen? But you got to do your own investigation. I'm like we are. You investigate things. You don't settle for what people tell you. Amen? If you don't check it out, they'll charge you whatever they want. They'll just go crazy on you. I had some else fixed. They wanted, $1,800 days. I had it fixed for less than $100 off eBay. I'm an eBay shopper. Amen. eBay. I'm not going to pay all that money for something I can get off eBay. So we have to research things, saints. Just to open your pockets up, because these guys will wear you out. They will take every dime. They will mistreat you and won't fix the problem. And a lot of times, women need to get a man with them. They'll take advantage of war. That's a shame what they do. You take a man with you. If they didn't, but your son came with you. Anybody look like a man came with you. Now I'm not talking about somebody, you know what I'm talking about. I mean a man. But you need to have a man with you before you start making decisions. And my wife also, well, they always give you a different part. Yeah, because I don't accept it. They want somebody to do the church. Yeah, I want $1,000 for this. I said, no. I called him back, I'll give you $850. He said, I take it. He probably took $750. But see, I want to be fair too now. I want to be fair. I want to treat people right, but I don't want you to take all my. This is church money, not my money. When I'm working for a church, I get real tight. I am so squeaky tight when it comes to the church. I try to keep, this money's not mine, it's belonging to you. So I try to work real hard to keep things in line. And that's what we should do. The parking lot, all that stuff that I negotiate, because that's my line of business. I've been in business, so I know business. So if you don't know business, you need to talk to somebody that know business. I'm not a mechanic, I can't fix a car. You can deal with people that know and you trust. Get you a good mechanic, a good doctor, and somebody you can trust. Doctors make more money on prescription than they do on servicing you. The money is in the pharmaceutical companies. doctors make a killing on just the medication. That's why you're telling me go get something new for you. Try this, try that. But do you ever get a refund, a discount? Do you take the old medicine back? No. You got a whole cabinet full of medicine. And you get it in with it, throw it away. So, don't just take one man advice. Go to another doctor. If he don't treat you right, go to Greensboro. Go to Winston-Salem. Go to Chapel Hill. Just don't sell anything, saints. The doctor will kill you. And well, some are good, some are not so good. But you can't take everything. You gotta be careful. I'm not a doctor, I'm just telling you, you can't take everything. You can't do it. If you want to die quick, you keep taking that stuff. It'll make you sick. We get ready to move on. We thank God for you. The preachers had some are working, some are doing different things, but we are moving forward. And we doing the will of God. I got one question for you. Who do you love the Lord with all your heart? I mean, do you really, really, really love the Lord? Do you actually love me? What do you do when you get excited about it? You stand up and you give God a praise, right? Do you really, really, really? Yeah. Whoa. Oh. Do you love me? Do you really love me? Do you walk out on faith with me? Do you really care for me? Sincerely. Sincerely. Oh. He asked my man, Peter, do you love me? Peter said, Lord, you know I love me. The man Peter, the man got tough. Peter denied twice, three times. So the question is, will you deny me or do you love me? Whoa. But at the time of test, he denied him. A lot of folks still love you, but when testing time comes, you really see who really loves you.
Amen.
When things get tough, you really know who loves you. When your hair starts falling out, your teeth fall out, and you weigh 300 pounds more than you used to weigh, but can you still love me? They trading people in like they do cars. But will you love me the way I am? With all my problems and situations, can you still love me? That's what God was asking Peter. Can you still love me? No matter what you go through, saints, you gotta be committed to this thing called salvation. It's not a weekend thing, it's Sunday only thing. But can you love me? See, God has to, sometimes he approves his love in those tough times. When everybody walk away from you, can you still love me? Can you still love me? He said, if you eat my body and drink my blood, you have no part in me. The Bible said people, the disciples walked away and walked with it no more. People will walk away from you.
Yes, sir.
People will let you down. Don't you put your confidence in folks. You put your confidence in my Savior. He'll never leave you. Lord, will he forsake you? Somebody ought to give God a praise. I'm talking to somebody right now. You can put your confidence in family, friends, and job, and this, that, and the other. You put your confidence in a Savior that will never let you down. You put your confidence in him.
Thank you, Lord.
I hope my wife put my confidence, her confidence in me. Because I'll die and leave her. But Jesus will never leave me. He'll be there to the end of the world. Can anybody give God thank you, praise? He will stay with you. He will be there for you. Because he's God. And we are not God. And it sounds quiet. We're going to start selection. We're going to get our offering. I feel praise in my spirit this morning. I feel a praise. Hallelujah. Glory to God. You ever feel like running sometimes? You just feel like you've been dancing and hopping and giving God a thank you, praise. Thank you.
Facebook, so it's not working.